Presented by Church Tech U, it's the ProPresenter Show. On today's show, how to use CCLI's SongSelect with ProPresenter 7. Hi, and welcome again to the ProPresenter Show. This is the show where I teach all about ProPresenter. My name's Paul Allen Clifford. And before we get started, if you've been curious why I haven't yet tackled the topic of SongSelect, go ahead, like, subscribe, click the little bell icon, all that fun jazz. So, to answer the question as to why I'm just now getting to this, ProPresenter 7 came out in January of 2020, and here we are in 2024. Why haven't I covered this? This is kind of a basic thing. CCLI won't sell me a login to SongSelect. So, it was on my to-do list for like 4 years to get it from my church. And this past Sunday, I finally did. So, let's head over to my computer and we'll take a look at just everything that's involved. So, here we are in ProPresenter, and there are a couple of places that you can log into SongSelect. If you click the search, or Command F on a Mac, Control F on Windows, you'll see the second icon here. That's SongSelect by CCLI. If you're not logged in, you can click on that and it'll take you to the login page. Another place to do it is if you go to ProPresenter and either Settings or Preferences, depending on your operating system of your computer, and you go down here to Services. Remember, this isn't church services, this is third-party services. So, SongSelect and Planning Center and Resi and just all those things are not included with ProPresenter. There are other companies that Renewed Vision is working with within inside ProPresenter. So we have Planning Center that I'm logged into, Multitracks that I'm logged into, and SongSelect. And you'll notice that that's a church name, and that's because that is, in fact, my church's name. So I finally got a login here, so you can log in right here. That's how you do that. Do you like these videos, but you'd really like to learn from me in person? Well, I've got some great news for you. I am traveling around the country and maybe even around the world training churches on how to use ProPresenter. So I've got either a 1 or 1.5 day class that you can attend. For more details, head on over to TDM.fyi/events24, the top one right here, and register for the event nearest you. If there is no event that's near you, no problem, you can request one. So head on over to TDM.fyi/class request, that's this one down here, and you can say, hey, I'm interested in attending a class, or even I'm interested in hosting a class. Up to you which you prefer. In the last one, that is just information. It's not obligation, so don't hesitate to put your information in there, and I'll let you know when there's a class in your area, or we'll talk about what it takes to host a class. It's probably a lot less than you imagine that it is. So, head over there, and I look forward to meeting you in person. But once you've done that, let's say that you want to add a new song. Well, it's just as easy as doing a search. So the first icon here, this is what's already in ProPresenter. That's the ProPresenter logo. This is the Multitracks logo. So if you've got Multitracks, that's where you do this. But today, we're talking about SongSelect by CCLI. So let me just do a search for a song. Might help if I typed in the thing correctly. Turn Your Eyes Upon Jesus. And that gives you an example of the text. It doesn't show you the entire thing. But then you just click Import. And once you do that, I've said this before, but while we're here, might as well explain this. This top box is asking where to break the text. So let's say that my worship leader says, I want two lines per slide, well, then what I'll do is I'll change slides delimited by from the default, which was paragraph break, to line break. And then this box is how many of whatever is up here. So line break, two of them. Two line breaks is two lines per slide. Now we have the size of my largest screen, a theme, which is like a template or a stencil, if you want to think of it that way, for how you want it to look. And I've chosen one that should work fine. Then what library you want to put it in. Notice I've got a bunch over here. Since this is, it's kind of hymny, kind of worshipy, so I'm going to just go with the music library, which is where I put my worship songs. And then the playlist, the name of the playlist that you want to add it to. So you can choose any of those there. I'm just going to put it in the default one because that's the one we're playing with. So I click import. And it brings it in. Now, one thing that you might notice is this is more than two lines. And that's because this particular theme has larger text. So what I could do is click up here, upper left-hand corner, and just click the little down arrow and see if I can just tweak it. And you'll notice that this one already went back. So it affects all these slides, and this particular one, it's diverging from what my theme was, but right now I have it to where it's all two lines per slide. So I'm good to go there. Notice that it imported it with the verse, chorus, verse, ending all in there. So that's good. I could then click up here to go to the arrangements and make whatever arrangement or arrangements that I wanted. One thing that I always want to do, I think this is a best practice, by the way, is click add a new blank slide. And I'm going to put that blank slide right here at the very beginning and right click and add that to a group, let's say maybe the intro. And then that way I can put a background on it if I want, because backgrounds are persistent until they're replaced or removed. I can add actions, I can add macros, anything that I want to do. I've got tutorials for all of those, by the way. And I tell my operators, always click on the first slide, even if you have to immediately click on the second slide. So now that's good to go. I could bring that in. One thing I wanted to show you that it also does, if I right click and select edit slide here, before I've clicked on anything in here, it shows me the copyright information. So that was brought in correctly, and it's good to go. This year seems wrong to me, but maybe that's because this particular arrangement was from 2016, because I think originally it came from much earlier. So that could be what's going on there. But anyway, that is how you add the how you add CCLI lyrics using SongSelect in ProPresenter 7. If you like this content, you'd probably like my ProPresenter 7 Quick Start course, so head on over to tdm.fyi/pro, the number 7 and quick. Give me your name and email address, and I'll make a login for you for free. Until next time, this is Paul Allen Clifford from TrinityDigitalMedia.com and ChurchTechU.com, reminding you to go out and change eternity.